this was the roadway that was in by hydro. We managed to put the pad location just off to the right of it. So no, we didn't have to build this. We did have to level the grade a little bit to improve the access in, but very minor changes. Again, this area is just absolutely beautiful for us.
All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Mike Stark. He is the CEO of Arizona Gold and Silver. And Mike, joining us from the Philadelphia project this morning. Good to see you again, Mike.
Likewise, Steve. Thanks. It's a really nice, balmy 70 degrees here in Arizona today.
Good stuff. Well, let's talk about what's going on. Now, obviously, there's a drill over your shoulder. So that means the work has begun after securing those permits.
Yes. So this is our 40-hole program, and commencing on pad one, this is pad one over my shoulder. We can do up to 20 holes here, 20 holes on pad two, which is about 600 meters to the north. Again, this is the exciting time for us now. The hypothesis is that this is where the mineral source likely comes from, and therefore, drilling down dip of some of our best intercepts before, 1.34 over 150 meters, 1.57 over 110 meters, providing we're successful going down dip, the grade should increase based on the open district, which is what we are, the open district here. If the grades continue to get better, we're proving up our hypothesis, and then the story really gets exciting.
Yeah, let's talk about what this program is going to do. You mentioned the number of holes. You're obviously going to start with just the first hole. So what kind of depths are you going to get to?
Well, first hole is designated around 800, 900, 1,000, and it'll be a fan of four. Once those are complete and we like what we see, we'll move it over and do another fan of four from the same pad. This, again, as we get deeper, Steve, the nice thing to have Mark on the drill rig is if we like what we're seeing, even if we're down to 1,000 feet, we'll continue. We want to run this as long and as deep as we can, giving the real true depths of what our mineralization here is.
Okay. We also should point out that you're actually standing on a roadway. So where you're drilling right now, pretty accessible. It's got good infrastructure, it sounds like.
You know, Steve, we're very fortunate here. This was a roadway that was in by hydro. We managed to put the pad location just off to the right of it. So no, we didn't have to build this. We did have to level the grade a little bit to improve the access in, but very minor changes. Again, this area is just absolutely beautiful for us.
Yeah. And lastly, Mike, I would imagine this is a really important day and an important time for the company getting to this particular point. Can you sort of talk about the excitement around yourself and the team as you get the drill start turning?
It is, Steve. Like I like to use the phrase, this is the TSN turning point. Look, upon successful here, we prove up the hypothesis that Greg has been working on for the last 4 years. This is the heat source, we believe, where the mineralization has come from. And it's bled out over the 3 kilometer length of strike that we see. Now we're testing it. It's taken us a long time to get this permit. We're happy to have it. Upon success on maybe first one or two holes, we'd have, like, it's never a guarantee until you drill it. But if we see what we like to see now, it's a proven for us, and it's very exciting times for the company. Absolutely very exciting times.
All right, we'll leave it there, Mike. Continued success. We will check in with you again. Really appreciate the time. Thank you.
Likewise. Thanks, Steve. Take care now.
All right, you as well. There's Mike Stark, the CEO of Arizona Gold and Silver, joining us from their Philadelphia project.